Finally, we have Yu-Gi-Oh! The Dawn of Destiny. I can't believe I'm 90-something games in, and only now am I doing my first original Xbox game. I used to have a pirate copy of this game back when I had a chipped Xbox. This copy I bought in July or August of 2020 as part of a big post-breakup cheer myself up by buying shit spree after spending a day watching a speedrun. I watched Yu-Gi-Oh! Loads as a kid, bought loads of the cards and all that. I fell off after the airing of the Waking the Dragon story arc. Apparently new episodes were airing, but I just couldn't find them anywhere and I just fell off the series eventually. It always stayed a little relevant in my mind thanks to the Yu-Gi-Oh! Via Bridge series and my ex having an on-off hobby of collecting the cards. But what really got me into it again lately was discovering Seymour's two series, the Yu-Gi-Oh! Progression series and the History of Yu-Gi-Oh! The former I found about 4 episodes in during my low point and it was something I really needed in that time, just something to laugh at with a little bit of nostalgia. I'm not interested in playing the card game seriously myself or collecting the cards again, but it did cause an itch I'm scratching with this game. Originally I had a different idea for this video. I was going to be doing a Professor Oak's challenge of this game. If you don't know, it's a challenge in Pokemon games where you must collect every possible Pokemon before every gym battle, even if it means tens of hours of grinding early game. But how does this apply to Yu-Gi-Oh? Here I was going to get the highest possible card amount before unlocking a new character. I start with 3 Duel Machines and must unlock other opponents through the Triple Duel mode. I'll let you know the point where I gave up on this idea. There are 1,017 cards total in this game, and I start with a 43 card starter deck. The 3 possible decks to start with determined by the name you enter, based around having one strong card. There's the Trihorn Dragon deck, the Zera the Mant deck, which is a default choice for speedrunners, but I have to enter the name Konami to guarantee the Cosmo Queen deck. Why this one? Well, it's because this deck has the smallest amount of cards obtainable as prizes through the default duel machines, meaning the highest possible card count just from dueling them. This deck starts with Ancient Sorcerer, Anti-Raigeki, Barrel Rock, Big Insect, Bioplant, Buku, Book of Secret Arts, Cosmo Queen, Cyber Soldier of the Dark World, Dancing Elf, Dark Assailant, Dark Energy, Dark Shade, Dark Titan of Terror, Dokuro Rider, Dorova, Gemini Elf, Harpy's Feather Duster, Invader from Another Dimension, Jirai Gumo, Keymace No. 2, Killer Needle, King Fog, Lord of the Lamp, Magician of Faith, Muyan Curry, Mystery Hand, Mystical Elf, Needleball, Oguchi, Phantom Doan, Revival of Dokuro Rider, Royal Decree, Serpent Marauder, Skull Dice, Tainted Wisdom, Tower of Chanter, Three-Legged Zombies, Two-Pronged Attack, Witty Phantom, Yaiba Robo, Yami, and Zone Eater. Just 964 to go. So, to single duel where I had the 3 duel machines to play against and 110 new cards to obtain. I'm going to start with Duel Machine 3 because I simply need some stronger monsters to replace the garbage clogging my deck. I won't go into the rules and just assume if you're watching this you know how the game works, even vaguely. That and I never really knew how to play the game as a kid and I don't want to show my arse. But in my first game I'm screwed right away as the duel machine gets Vorce Raider on its first turn. Vorce Raider has 1900 attack points and my Gemini Elf and Jiraigumo are the only normal summon monsters I have that can match it. My starting selection of spells and traps is rubbish too, aside from Feather Duster and Royal Decree. So I'm just stuck setting monsters in defense waiting for some kind of out. The AI in this game is both an incredible cheater and incredibly stupid. It knows every card you have face down and can act accordingly. It also makes some idiot moves. For example, in this game I activate Royal Decree, which blocks off the effects of all of the trap cards. However, it still activates its traps to no effect and wastes them. I mean, I don't mind. The less usable jars of greed it has, the better. It doesn't matter though because my inability to fight back as it summons more monsters lets it get out a Jinzo and a summon skull and just annihilate me. In my second match, things go a little better. I get out 2 monsters to tribute for Cosmo Queen with its 2900 attack and an Noguchi to directly chip away a few life points each turn with its effect. However, despite seeing it in the speedrun, I destroy the opponent's Slate Warrior with Cosmo Queen, forgetting its effect of lowering the attack points of its killer by 500. The machine just so happened to have the cards to ritual summon Magician of Black Chaos the very next turn and stop me dead in my tracks. It looks like I can turn it around when I draw Jiraigumo, which has just enough attack points to kill one of the other monsters and win me the game, but it gets trap hold and I lose again. Third match also gets a bad start when the machine draws the 1800 attack large in on its first turn, which also outmatches all my level 4 and lower monsters aside from Gemini Elf and Jiraigumo. Then it pulls out Jinzo and I get my quickest loss yet. Then the fourth try, it gets another Vorce Raider on the first turn. However, I actually managed to get my Jiraigumo out and the 50-50 chance of losing half my life points on attacking is worth it right now to get rid of its beaters. This time I keep all its monsters down and Jiraigumo ends up with the perfect amount of attack points to get my first win. I have to choose between 3 statues of the Egyptian gods to win some cards. Everything I need is in Ra right now, so I pick that and get Hard Armor, Fiend Sword, and Grand Tiki Elder. 2 of these aren't amazing, but they're improvements over what I have. However, not being used to the original Xbox controller layout after a few years not using it, I accidentally agreed to another match thinking I was pressing the cancel button. I lose. I go to my deck and replace Dancing Elf and Serpent Marauder with Fiend Sword and Grand Tiki Elder. For my next match, I draw Gemini Elf on my first turn along with Yami and Book of Secret Arts to power it up enough that it remains unstoppable and gets me another win. This time the Ra statue gets me Dragon Statue and Unknown Soldier of Fiend, along with a second Fiend Sword. They all go into the deck, replacing Dorova, Phantom Duan and Buku. Then in my next match I get Gemini Elf, Yami and Royal Decree on my first turn for another win. Ra again for Skull Stalker and two Vorce Raiders. Now this is what I was after. Not the Skull Servant, but with the two Vorce Raiders replacing Zonita and Mystery Hand, I now have a couple more beaters that can match the machines. My next win gets me Stuffed Animal, which replaces Bioplant. On my next win I get Wood Clown and two more good beaters, Slate Warrior and Largin the Mystical Genie of the Lamp. Those two replace Invader from Another Dimension and Barrel Rock. Next win gets me Raimundos of the Red Sword and Kage Ningen. They replace King Fog and the second stuffed animal I got replaces Dark Shade. Another win gets me a second Largin and third Vorce Raider, which replace Unknown Warrior Feed and Yaibarobo. I'm doing better, but that doesn't mean I'm winning every match now. In one, just getting my Largin trap hold first turn led to me getting wiped out. Another win gets me a Doron and a third Largin, replacing Key Mace number 2 and the three-legged zombies with the third stuffed animal I won. Next win gets me a second Grand Tiki Elder to replace Oguchi. Next I win a rare Premature Burial and replace Needle Ball. I then get a third Grand Tiki Elder to replace the Dragon Statue. A second Slate Warrior replaces Dark Assailant. Next I get Guardian of the Labyrinth, followed by a third Slate Warrior to replace Big Insect. At this point I stop getting new cards for a while. All I'm missing from Duel Machine 3's Ra Statue is a spell card and two traps. Both of these card types have incredibly low drop rates for whatever reason, so what follows is just me getting many duplicates of no use to me. I do get another example of Stupid AI, where the Duel Machine wastes its one Premature Burial on a hero of all things. 2 hours later I finally pull another spell and it's a second Premature Burial, which is limited to one per deck so I can't even use it. My next win gets me a Trap Hole which replaces Ancient Sorcerer, just two cards left from the Ra Statue. During this I'm reminded of a decision I fucking hate. If you play an equip card and don't have a target on your board because you simply mixed up types or whatever, you cannot back out and are forced to equip it on one of your opponent's monsters if they have one compatible. Of course in this case it didn't matter because the idiot went and feather dusted the equip on their own monster. Eventually I reached the point where I've been dueling the same machine and picking the same statue for 6.5 hours and I still don't have those last two cards from it. I need to mix things up before I burn out, so I move on to Duel Machine 1. Thanks to my better cards, my first match against this one goes much quicker. I do get stuck behind a Millennium Shield for a bit because I have nothing that hits over its 3000 defense. I have to wait and draw Yami to give Cosmo Queen just those few extra attack points to take it out so the wall of beaters I built up in the meantime can destroy it. I pick the Ra statue again and get Mushroom Man and Firegrass. Sticking with Ra for a while, my second win gets me Maneater and Living Vase, followed by Yashinoki. Win 4 gets me Dark World Thorns and Millennium Shield, the latter replaces Anti-Raigeki. I then get Haniwa from my 5th win. Further wins get me Psychic Kappa and Dark Plant, then later a Snatch Steal, which I swap out Killer Needle for. A little later I get Gamble. After a few games of nothing new, I win a Morphing Jar, which replaces a stuffed animal. At one point we get locked with me on a row of beaters held back by a single Millennium Shield, and my Royal Decree blocking traps. The machine had the chance to change things up with a Mystical Space Typhoon, but instead decided to destroy my currently useless face down trap hole instead, allowing me to just deck it out. Like the Premature Burial, after many wins and getting duplicates, I get a second Snatch Steal I can't use. Another idiot AI moment. The opponent had 6 cards left in its deck and decided to use Gamble in my battle phase, ensuring me attacking its set Morphing Jar would deck it out. I later get Torrential Tribute, which replaces Skull Dice in my deck. I follow that up even later by getting Cyber Jar, which replaces a stuffed animal. I leave the rarer stuff for now and start choosing the Obelisk statue. I get Laughing Flower, Barrel Lily, Snake Yashi, Abyss Flower, Man-Eating Plant and Mystic Tomato. The tomato replaces Raimundos. I then get Tentacle Plant, Ancient Tree of Enlightenment, Green Phantom King, Bean Soldier and the second Mystic Tomato. Those latter two replace Tower of Chanter and my last stuffed animal. I then get Eye Armor before once again leaving the rarest drops for now and moving on to the Slifer statue. The first one gets me a Mystical Space Typhoon that replaces Tainted Wisdom, followed by a Just Desserts that replaces my Dark Titan, a Negate Attack that replaces Yami, a Magic Thorn, a Jar of Greed that replaces Two-Pronged Attack, a Solemn Wishes that replaces Millennium Shield, and finally a Magic Jammer that replaces Just Desserts. That's everything but Slifer's rarest drops. I then move on to Duel Machine 2. There's no commons I want over others, so I just start with the Obelisk statue, getting Gruesome Goo, Giant Soldier of Stone and Maneater Bug. The latter two replace Lord of the Lamp and Mystical Elf. My next win gets me Hitoden Chak and the Melting Red Shadow. Continuing on I get Weffa, Monsturtle, a Dragon Zombie that replaces Fiend Sword, Kappa Avenger, the Furious Sea King, Twin Long Rods No. 1, Aquasnake, Toadmaster, Turtle Raccoon, Armored Zombie, Zarigun and Kanikabuto. I then move on to picking the Ra statue for Turupurun, Twin Long Rods No. 2, Trachodon, Liquid Beast, Frog the Jam, the Judgment Hand, Ice Water, Change Slime and Gravity Bind. I then move on to the Slifer statue. I get Axe of Despair, which replaces Witty Phantom, and United We Stand, which replaces Cyber Soldier. At one point I'm stuck behind Gravity Bind so long I'm able to get Cosmo Queen out and equip it up to 7900 attack. Immediately after I Royal Decree, it gets Mani a Bug before I can put that attack to use. I then get Griffin Wing before moving back to Duel Machine 3. Picking Obelisk, I get M Warrior number 1, Moon Envoy, M Warrior number 2, Hero of the East, Supporter in the Shadows, Kagemusha of the Blue Flame, Armail, Oscillo Hero, Massacre of the Legendary Swordsman, Monster Egg, Dehuman, and Hyo. That's every common from the Duel Machines, I only have the rares left. Keeping with Obelisk, I get 7 Tools of the Bandit and Tribute to the Doomed, which replaces Bean Soldier. Then I had a few hours getting nothing new. The way card drops work is that each card has a weight value that is multiplied by a decimal as you get more of them, up to a 0.1 multiplier for having 3. Most of the commons have a weight of 100, reduced to 10 after getting 3 of them, but every card I have left has a weight of 5, or 0, which is rounded up to 5. So even with 3 of all the 100 weight cards, they're still far more common than everything I don't have. Another example of stupid AI? It used Premature Burial without enough life points to survive and just killed itself. While all this is going on, I should bring up the promotional cards that came with the game, Widespread Ruin, Dark Sage, and the Winged Dragon of Ra. Of course, since my original copy was a pirate copy, it didn't come with any. I saw that image of Winged Dragon of Ra on the back of the case and wished it was a proper copy so much. A lot of us back then didn't care too much for how useful the cards were, we just wanted the ones we recognised from the anime. So when I saw a legitimate copy in the supermarket, I genuinely considered spending 6 weeks worth of pocket money just for that card. But then I saw on the back of the box that for the actual PAL release, they removed only Ra and replaced it with Mesmeric Control. Imagine the disappointment. I wasn't going to spend £30 on a game I already had that didn't come with a god card. I still don't know why they made that change. Back in primary school, none of us knew how to play the game. It's not like the Duelist Kingdom episodes gave you any idea either. A game of Yu-Gi-Oh! On the one day you were allowed to bring your cards to school was instead of a deck, you drop down your entire 300 plus card collection and purposely rig the shuffle so you draw blue eyes and summon it first turn with no attributes. Also, you fully refilled your hand to 5 at the beginning of every turn. But at least we were willing to try. Not a single person in my friend group, myself included, had the patience to learn and play even one full match of the Pokemon TCG. And I don't think anyone truly realised that the even less popular, but still around in our area, Digimon cards were even used in the game. Hell, I never saw a single booster pack of the Digimon cards in a shop. The few I had were traded for with Pokemon cards. But back to the game. At this point I was starting to regret doing this challenge, especially when I went an entire day not getting a single new card because the drop rates on spells and traps were decided by cunts. I get having rare drops, but I don't get giving them dickhead rarity. Spending an entire day beating Duel Machine 1 and picking Obelisk waiting for a magic cylinder that never came is very demoralising. 15 and a half hours of gameplay getting nothing new later and I get Backup Soldier from the Slifer Statue after beating Duel Machine 1. All I had left to get were cards with a weight of 0, and after many 2-hour recording sessions, I just had to give up on the Professor Oak challenge. Supposedly, a weight of 0 is the same as having a weight of 5 as the game rounds it up, but I'm not sure. I'd been playing these same 3 opponents for 47 and a half hours total. I had won a total of 510 games, which at 3 cards a win meant a total of 1530 cards won. I had many 5 weight cards by then, but not a single 0 weight. I was missing 16 of these 0 weight cards, and not winning a single one after that amount of time and wins makes me consider how long it would take to get all 16, and I come to the conclusion that it was just not worth the time investment. What I will do though, to keep some level of structure, is dial it back a bit. I'll keep the same rules, but only aim for cards with a weight higher than 0. It's not a proper Professor Oak's challenge, but it's the closest reasonable thing. This does mean rewriting my list of needed cards, and possibly changing the order I unlock these characters. It also means that in the end, with the Duel Machines, I gained 94 new cards. This brought my total to 137 out of 1017 and 13% of all cards collected. So now I'll move on to the mode of unlocking new characters, Triple Duel. There are 15 tiers of 3 characters that I can challenge in any order I want, and the character I defeat last is unlocked in Single Duel. I have a set amount of life points that then carry over across all 3 duels, and losing means I have to start that tier again. First is Yugi, his grandfather, and Shimon. Originally Grandpa was first having the most new cards available, but thanks to not going for 0 weights, it changed. In order of most new cards available, it goes Yugi at 87, then Grandpa at 81, and Shimon at 79. Most of these cards are shared between them, so that number will drop for the other two. I have 6,000 life points while Shimon and Grandpa have 2,000 each and Yugi has 3,000. Thanks to all the high attack beaters and the good traps and equip spells, it's over very quick. Grandpa and Yugi were beaten in a single battle phase while Shimon just took 2. When choosing a statue after winning a triple duel, you'll instead get 5 cards. I pick Slifer after beating Yugi and get Fire Eye, Cockroach Knight, Tomozaurus, Yamatano Dragon Soul, and Warrior Elimination. Now that Yugi is available in single duel, I get to work. I start with the Obelisk statue, winning Great White, Horn Imp, Battle Warrior, Silver Fang, Feral Imp, Komori Dragon, and Mammoth Graveyard. I then move on to the Ra statue, winning Zombie Warrior, Blackland Fire Dragon, Sangan, Torike, and Winged Dragon Guardian of the Fortress No. 1. Then alternate Obelisk and Ra until I get Skull Servant. Then moving on to the Slifer Statue, Eyewing Griffore, Curse of Dragon, Celtic Guardian, Baby Dragon, Beaver Warrior, Alpha the Magnet Warrior, Gamma the Magnet Warrior, Polymerization, Gaia the Fierce Knight, Time Wizard, and Beta the Magnet Warrior, which replaces the last remaining Fiend Sword in my deck. Then I get Gazelle, the King of Mythical Beasts, which for some reason is on the same level of rarity as Gaia the Dragon Champion, which I get 10 minutes later. That's all for single duel, but there are many cards that can only be won through triple duel. So, sticking with the Slifer Statue in Triple Duel, I win Flame Viper, La La Lioon, Wings of Wicked Flame, Key Maze, Caterpillar, Weather Control, Petite Dragon, Petite Moth, Digbeak, Happy Lover, Dharma Cannon, Lucky Trinket, Candle of Fate, Ancient Jar, Hourglass of Life, Air Marmot of Nefariousness, The Bewitching Phantom Thief, Kuribo, Hurricale, Mystical Capture Chain, Embryonic Beast, Korogashi, Pot the Trick, Ganigumo, Kaminari Kozo, White Dolphin, Masked Clown, Midnight Fiend, and finally, Polymerization again, but using the art from the anime. This makes it count as a separate card, so you could have 6 Polymerizations in your deck if you have 3 of each. You shouldn't do that, but you could if you want to. As someone who was introduced through the anime, I was disappointed seeing the actual Polymerization art, so being able to get the better looking anime one is something I appreciate. Not that I'll ever be using Polymerization because none of the fusion monsters in this game are worth it. After that, I move on to the Ra statue, getting Phantom Ghost, Wicked Mirror, Hinotama Soul, Droll Bird, Bat, Medabat, Shadow Spectre, Mega Thunderball, The Wandering Doomed, Mech Mole Zombie, Mayo Toko, Fiend's Hand, Dark Room of Nightmare, Wretched Ghost of the Attic, Cyber Commander, and Majin Gun. If you lose in Triple Duel, which is what happens when Yugi Magic Cylinders my powered up Gemini Elf with the exact same attack points as I have remaining life points, I still get to choose a statue, but instead get 3 cards. This gets me Mystical Sheep number 1 and Fungi of the Musk. Keeping with the Ra statue, I get Fire Reaper, Bone Mouse, Mechaleon, and Sectarian of Secrets before I move on to the Obelisk statue, for Gaia Power and Reinforcement of the Army, the latter replacing one of my Grand Tiki Elders. However, the card is useless right now because I have no warriors in my deck, having forgotten that Vorce Raider is a Beast Warrior. Keeping with Obelisk, I get the last 2 cards I need from Yugi, Curtain of the Dark Ones and Wing Cleaver. This puts me at 223 out of 1017 cards, or 21%. I suppose I should talk about Yugi himself. Right now his deck mainly exists to waste time before his inevitable defeat. Mainly weak monsters, but a lot of 2k defenders like Mystical Elf and Giant Soldier of Stone that just delay things until I get an Equip or Cyberjar. Plus, traps like Trap Hole and Negate Attack that only act to drag the game out a little longer because his only dangerous card right now is Summon Skull, which he never gets a chance to use because I'm destroying all the monsters he puts up before I can tribute them. And if he does have a monster out for tribute, more often for me he'd waste it on Summoning Curse of Dragon instead. He also has a bad habit of using Time Wizard's effect, which despite the 50-50 chance, backfired on him about 90% of the time. I honestly don't remember too much of Yugi in the show itself, since the Pharaoh does most of the dueling and he doesn't really get much of a chance to show his own skill off. Plus, as I said, I only watched up to the end of Waking the Dragons, in which he spends most of the arc not there since his soul gets stolen by the Seal of Orichalcos and its 12 million effects. At least he seemed pretty likable from what I remember, rather than an obnoxious over-enthusiastic loudmouth like a lot of other main characters in kids' anime at the time. Davis from Digimon Adventure 02 and Tyson from Beyblade come to mind. After removing the cards I already won from Yugi from the count, it leaves Grandpa at 27 cards to win and Shimon at 23, so Grandpa is next. I defeat him last in Triple Duel to unlock him but didn't win any new cards. I get right to work picking the Obelisk statue, getting Jin the Watcher of the Wind, Flame Manipulator, Necrolancer the Time Lord, Genin, Akakiesu, and Neo the Magic Swordsman. Neo replaces another Grand Tiki Elder, which I think will give Reinforcement of the Army some use, but Neo is a spellcaster, not a warrior. I then get Nemuriko, a second Neo to replace a dead Rota, Sorcerer of the Doomed, Left Arm of the Forbidden One, and Left Leg of the Forbidden One. That's everything from Obelisk, so I move on to the Ra statue and win Penguin Soldier, Aquamador, White Magical Hat, Right Leg of the Forbidden One, and after 2 hours, Pot of Greed, which replaces the last Grand Tiki Elder in my deck. Now to move on to the Slifer statue. I get the Illusory Gentleman, Exordia the Forbidden One, Right Arm of the Forbidden One, and Graceful Charity, which replaces the Giant Soldier of Stone. Now for the rewards from Triple Duel. From the Obelisk statue, I win Wodan the Resident of the Forest, Dragon Seeker, Soul Hunter, Sparks, and Second Coin Toss. All that's left is to move on to the Ra statue for UFO Turtle, Creowell, and finally, Hieroglyph Lithograph, getting me to 250 cards and 24%. His deck is an Exordia deck, filled with recruiters like Sangan, and loads of traps are stalling me like more Trap Holes, Torrential Tributes, Negate Attacks, plus Penguin Soldier. He managed to Exordia me once as a kid, but it never happened once here. As for Solomon himself, I don't have much to say. He's out for Duelist Kingdom due to his soul being pinched, and after he gets it back, I don't remember him doing too much other than shitty tired old perv gags that despite being rewritten in the dub, you can still tell that's what they always were. Next is to once again go through Triple Duel, but with Shimon as the last opponent to unlock him. I pick the Slifer statue and get Rainbow Flower, Mushroom Man number 2, and Steel Scorpion. I then go back into single duel for the next grind, starting with the obelisk statue. I win Minamushi Warrior, Stone Armadillo, Rock Ogre Grotto number 2, Destroyer Golem, Dissolver Rock, Stone Ghost, and the thing that hides in the mud. I then move on to the Ra statue, winning the Statue of Easter Island, Prizman, Fire Yarrow, Upstart Goblin, and Fairy Box. I then move on to triple duel, picking an obelisk. I get Swordsman from a Foreign Land, Griggle, and Legle before moving on to Ra. This gets me Monster Eye, Rose Spectre of Dawn, Vermilion Sparrow, and Molten Destruction. I then go to the Slave of Statue for the last card from Shimon, Trent. This gets me a total of 273 cards at 26%. Shimon plays a similar deck to Grandpa, but without the Exodia pieces and no 2k defenders. So basically he plays a deck that's easy to beat if you're playing the game normally, but a fucking pain if you're grinding in for cards like I am. Half his deck just exists to slow the game down. It's just a load of Penguin Soldiers, Trap Holes, Negate Attacks, and Torrential Tributes. And that's normal for a regular game of Yu-Gi-Oh! To have a back and forth, but when I have to beat him tens of times to win certain cards, it's a huge slog if I don't draw Royal Decree first turn. Shimon is the only character in this game I had no clue about when I first played the game as a kid. Apparently he worked for the Pharaoh back in his own time, so I guess he's a Season 5 character, which makes me not knowing anything about him make sense. Maybe he had some cameos earlier, but I don't remember, it's been over 15 years. Also, is it Shimon or Simon in the dub? I know Shimon is just the Japanese pronunciation, but that's what they go with in this. But the 5 seconds I played of Forbidden Memories years ago had him as Simon. It's now time to move on to Tier 2, consisting of Taya, Tristan and Joey. I have 7,000 life points, Joey and Tristan have 3,000 and Taya has 2,000. In terms of new cards, Taya has 53, Tristan has 43 and Joey has 25, so Taya is the first one I'll be unlocking. Thanks to the same cards I used to dominate Tier 1, Tristan is beaten in a single battle phase, Joey in 2 and Taya in 3. I pick the Obelisk Statue and win Witch's Apprentice and Electric Snake. Then I stick to the Obelisk Statue in single duel, winning Eldeen, Water Magician, Fairy Witch, Nekogal No. 1, Lady of Faith, Beautiful Headhuntress, Water Emotics, Protector of the Throne, Musa A, Tripwire Beast, Fire Princess, Enchanting Mermaid, Nekogal No. 2, and Arlone. Then moving to the Ra Statue for Amazon of the Sea, Water Dragon Fairy, Fairy's Gift, Spirit of the Harp, Maiden of the Moonlight, The Forgiving Maiden, Bolt Penguin, Luna Queen Elzheim, Bolt Escargot, Dryad, Vishwa Randy, and a Dunami's Dark Witch that replaces my Beta in the deck. The remaining cards I need from this statue can also be one from the Slifer statue, so I move on to that. From this statue I get Water Element, Sonic Maid, Fairy of the Fountain, Ancient Elf, Marie the Fallen One, Water Girl, Saint Joan, Gift of the Mystical Elf, Kanan the Sword Mistress, Hibikime, Numinous Healer, after an hour, Aqua Chorus, after 3 more hours, Fusion Sage, and after another 3 hours and a total of 133 duels against Taya, I get Mage Power. This replaces the Dragon Zombie I should have replaced ages ago. All that's left now is a triple duel rewards, of which I have 10 to win. From the Obelisk Statue, I win Kaminari Attack, Empress Judge, Princess of Tsurugi, the Immortal of Thunder, Mystical Sand, and Goddess with the Third Eye. From Ra, I win Warrior of Tradition, and from Slifer, I win Queen's Double, Electric Lizard, the Unhappy Maiden, and finally, Elf's Light. This gets me at 328 cards and 32%. Taya uses a deck with all female monsters and more healing spells and traps than anyone else so far. This also means she has quite a few 2k defenders thanks to her multiple copies of Spirit of the Harp and the Forgiving Maiden. She also tends to use fusion monsters more than anyone else so far. Saint Joan can be a pain, but I have stuff like Mani, a Bug, Cyber Jar, Tribute to the Doomed, or a lot of equips to deal with it, the rest are no problem. Taya herself didn't really do much in the show itself, she was there for moral support mainly. People hated her thanks to her abundance of friendship speeches, but to be fair, Taya was never the one that pissed me off. It was Yugi himself in that duel with Joey being possessed by Marek. That fucking flashback about what good friends they were was repeated so much over those episodes. Hated it. One of those was also the first episode I ever watched. How it got me to come back, I do not remember. Next character to unlock is Tristan, who has 43 cards to win. When unlocking him in triple duel, I choose the Obelisk Statue and win Milos Radiant, Hane Hane, and Giant Rat. Sticking with Obelisk in single duel wins me Battle Ox, Pale Beast, Wolf Axe Wielder, Obese Marmot of Nefariousness, Solitude, Armoured Rat, Burglar, Gate Deeg, Sinkar, Will Me, Larvas, Mukamuka, Mountain Warrior, Lysark, One Who Hunts Souls, Prevent Rat, Master and Expert, Ogre of the Black Shadow, Frenzied Panda, Dark Grey, Mystic Horseman, and Megamorph. I then start picking the Ra Statue for Goblin Attack Force, Mon Larvas, Mystical Sheep No. 2, Great Bill, Sleeping Lion, and Horn of the Unicorn. Then from Slifer I win Black Pendant, Sword of Deep Seated, and Enchanted Javelin. Those last four took about 4 or 5 hours altogether by the way. The last few cards I needed from Triple Duel took no time at all though. From the Obelisk Statue I got Arm Ninja, Fusionist, Mother Grizzly, Sengen Jin, and Mystical Moon. From Slifer I got Little Chimera and Cherubin the Fire Knight. Finally from Ra I get Beast Fangs and Green Kappa. This brings me to 369 out of 1017 cards, or 36%, which is where I'll be leaving it this episode. But first, I've got to talk about Tristan. I guess he's going for a beatdown deck with the three goblin attack forces, but he doesn't get to do much. His goblins switch to defense mode after attacking, so I can steamroll them. His 2k defenders also don't last long, and he doesn't have as many. He has Dokuro Rider, which is a ritual summon with equal attack points to most of my regular monsters. He is genuinely the easiest opponent so far. My own beatdown deck just tramples him. I never once lost a single duel against him. I have even less to say about Tristan than I did with Taya. Now he really didn't do too much. Except for fist fights, he was good at those, I remember. But this wasn't a show about fighting. I mean, if it was, he could have solved Battle City himself by just decking Merrick in the face and calling it a day. I remember him being in a single duel to which he suicided a few turns in. There was also that creepy thing with him and Duke competing over Joey's underage sister. Even as a kid, it never entertained me. But yeah, that's all for Yu-Gi-Oh! Dawn of Destiny this episode. This is the longest amount of time I spent recording a game for a single video in a single episode. Almost 100 hours were spent grinding out those cards. When you win some good cards to replace the garbage you start with, the game can be enjoyable, especially when you get into a groove winning new cards, but those rarer ones do bring the experience down. But the plan is to get around a third of the cards every episode, so we'll see how I feel when I'm finally done.